When I first saw you, I saw love. And the first time you touched me, I felt love. And after all this time, you're still the one I love.
Looks like we made it. Look how far we've come, my baby. We might have took the long way. We knew we'd get there someday. They said, I bet they'll never make it. But just look at us holding on. We're still together, still going strong. Still, you're still the one I run to, the one that I belong to. You're still the one I want for life. You're still the one that I
gathered here today to celebrate. Marriage, it is a contract, not to be entered into lightly, but rather entered into thoughtfully and seriously with a deep realization of its obligations and responsibilities. As your journey begins together today as husband and wife, I just want to ask you both to treat one another with the greatest and utmost respect. And when times are difficult, remind yourselves often of what it is that brought the two of you together in love in the first place. And of course, remember this moment, your wedding day. So Nigel, it's gonna seem like an awfully odd question because clearly she's in a white wedding dress and we're standing in a chapel, but the state says I must. So, do you take Kristen to be your lawfully wedded wife? To have and to hold, that's okay, every room does it. To have and to hold from this day forward. To love, honor, and cherish her in sickness and in health, forsaking all others for as long as you both shall live. Oh, I get married a lot. Kristen, repeat after me. Oh, I'm sorry, not yet. I'm sorry. Oh, my God, wait. Oh, my gosh. No, I'm going to ask you the same question, though.
Okay.
Do you take Nigel to be your lawfully wedded husband, to have and to hold from this day forward, to love, honor, and cherish him in sickness and in health, forsaking all others for as long as you both shall live?
I do.
I had a feeling you were going to say that. Why else are you dressed like this, right?
Yeah.
All right. I understand that we have rings.
Yes.
You'll each take one another's and then just hold on to them for a second.
You can. Oh, that's good.
All right. Take just a moment to reflect upon the rings. The rings are an unbroken circle. They represent unending love. For as often as the two of you will place your eyes upon these rings, or any other rings that you introduce while on this marital journey, may you be reminded that as of today, in just a moment, you are solidifying a lifelong commitment to one another. And of course, the true love never fails. And yay, nobody ran for it, so we're good. All right, Nigel, go ahead and place the ring on Kristen's finger, please, and repeat after me. Kristen, I give you this ring.
Kristen, I give you this ring.
As a token of my love and appreciation.
As a token of my love and appreciation.
And I give this ring with a promise.
And I give this ring with a promise.
I promise to continue loving you.
I promise to continue loving you.
Honoring you.
Honoring you.
And cherishing you.
And cherishing you.
All the remaining days of my life.
All the remaining days of my life.
All right. Kristen, you'll repeat after me as well. Nigel, I give you this ring.
Nigel, I give you this ring.
As a token of my love and appreciation.
As a token of my love and appreciation.
And I give this ring with a promise.
And I give this ring as a promise.
I promise to continue loving you.
I promise to continue loving you.
I do it all the time. Honoring you.
And honoring you.
And cherishing you.
And cherishing you.
All the remaining days of my life.
All the remaining days of my life.
So this is the part in the ceremony where the minister is supposed to give some sort of advice to the young couple. But I don't do that because I don't think anybody knows what they're doing. That's the truth. I'm just going to throw everybody under the bus.
Yeah.
None of us know what we're doing. It's one day into the next and so on. That's how it works. And people that have been together 100 years think that they have the right to offer unsolicited advice in your marriage. And just because it worked in theirs, it doesn't mean it's going to work in yours. So, just as the two of you are standing alone out here today, I think that the two of you probably have the best answers for your own problems. But should you look outside for any kind of help, that man right there, that's your guy, the one in red, he has a duty, because having been here today to witness your union, he also has a responsibility to see to it that this marriage is successful to the best of his ability.
Yeah.
And never to speak poorly about one or the other. All right. And to keep his confidentiality, too. Okay. So, I'm honored and I'm privileged to be a part of your ceremony, and I do mean that. I was married at the Excalibur 30 years ago.
Oh.
And this wizard man married us, but I didn't ask for one, he just was.
Yep.
But I'll never forget that man. If I were to see him today, I would know him. He's forever etched in my mind and in my heart. So I never had thought about that previously, at all. And then I never realized how often I would think of this man after. So, that said, I truly am honored that you've afforded me this opportunity. If the two of you are ready, the grand finality is upon us.
I forgot
about
that. Yeah. Okay. Ready? Finality. Are you ready?
Ready.
Okay. By the power vested in me by the great state of Nevada, it is truly my honor and my privilege to pronounce you husband and wife. You may kiss your bride.
Woo!
The only one I dream of is still the one I kiss. Good night. Ain't nothing better. We'd beat the odds together. I'm glad we didn't listen. Look at what we would be missing. They said, I bet they'll never make it. But just look at us holding on. We're still together, still going strong.